हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल। आई एम अंकिता भगत, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम सहजानंद इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल एट नाथेज। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन अवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी वर डिस्कस अबाउट एयर एक्सपांड ऑन हीटिंग एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑन कूलिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ एक्टिविटी। सो वी परफॉर्म एक्टिविटी 8.5 इन प्रीवियस सेशन, राइट? सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कंक्लूड दैट the air expand, so we conclude that the cold air occupies the less space whereas the hot air occupies the more space, it's increase its volume, right? So now we discuss about the next topic, that is the warm air is lighter than the cold air with an activity. So here activity 8.6 is given to you, right? So in this figure, you can see in this figure, take a two paper bags or two paper cups. So take a two empty paper bags and a two paper cups of the same size, right? And hang the two bags. Here given that, hang the two bags the inverted position. So here you can see in the figure, hang the bags in the inverted position, right? On the two ends of metal or wooden stick. So here take the metal or wooden stick and hang the two bags, right? Now tie a piece of thread in the middle of the stick and hold the stick by the thread as in a balance. Now what do after that? Tie a piece of thread. So here in figure, tie a piece of thread in middle and hold the stick by the help of thread. That's why it's a balanced properly, right? Now put a burning candle below one of the bag is shown in figure. So after that, what do? Put the burning candle of the one bag. Now observe what happened. So after a few seconds, we observe that the warm air rises up and it pushes the bags above the candle. The warm air rises up and it pushes the bag upside, right? Now what is the reason behind it? So the reason behind it is when the candle burns, the hot air is filled in the bag. Here when the candle burns, the hot air is filled in the bag. In the other, air is cool, so the hot air is lighter than the cold air. And hence the bag with the warm air becomes lighter and it is pushes upwards. Again I repeat, the hot air is lighter than the cold air. That's why the bag with warm air become lighter and it pushes upward direction. Got it? So here we conclude that, that's why we conclude that the warm air is lighter than the cold air. Got it? Now the another example with the same principle is when we fly a hot lightning balloon in the sky, right? So when we fly the hot lightning balloon in the sky, so usually we say that gubbara. I think you all are know about that. So I think you see that at the bottom of gubbara, at the bottom of lightning balloon, the fire source is given, right? The source of energy is given. So when we started this fire source, the hot air rises up. Same with the activity, the hot air, what? The hot air rises up in a balloon and it pushes the balloon in the sky, and the warm air is lighter than the called hair, right? Thus it is rises. Got it? Whereas the cold air is heavier than the hot air, so hence it is sinks down. So I hope you understand this activity. So here question is given, can you now explain why smoke always rises up? Why the smoke always rises up? So you know very well, the warm air is lighter than the cold air. That's why the smoke always goes up. So that's why the smoke always rises up, because the warm air is lighter. Got it? So here also given, in nature there are the several situations whereas the warm air is rises at a place and the air pressure at the place is lower. So when the warm air is rises, so at that place the pressure is lower. It means the low pressure is created at that place. Got it? And the cold air from the surrounding areas, so here cold air from the surrounding areas rushes to the low pressure. So here cold air from the surrounding area rushes towards to the low pressure and fill the gap. So we already learn in the chapter 4 in heat the convection method. Right? So this setup convection in air as you learned in the chapter 4. Right? So this is the convection method. Again I repeat, when the warm air rises up at that place the low pressure is created. So thus in surrounding area the cold air is rushes towards the low pressure and it fills the gap. It's same to the convection method. Right? So that's why we can say that the warm air is lighter than the cold air. Now the next topic we have, that is wind current are generated due to the uneven heating on earth. The wind current are generated due to the uneven heating on earth. So in this topic we will discuss about, we learn about how the wind current is generated, right? So in that there are the first one is uneven heating between equator and poles, and the second one in that is uneven heating of land and water. So before explaining, I will explain you one concept. There is the one important concept, right? Here you can see in the figure, when the sunlight, the sun rays falls on the earth's surface, at that time the air becomes warm. So the warm air expand in volume and it become lighter. So that's why the warm air rises up. So here you can see in the figure, when the sun rays falls on the earth's surface the air become hot and the warm air expand in volume, then it become light and it rises up. So at that place the low pressure is created. So why the low pressure created? Because the warm air rises up. So warm air rises up, that's why the low pressure is created. Got it? And when the low pressure is created at that time surrounding the high pressure. So in surrounding area the high pressure, it means the cold air. The cold air here, the cold air rushes towards the low pressure. That's why the wind move from high pressure to low pressure. So we conclude that always the wind move from the air मूव फ्रॉम हाई प्रेशर टू लो प्रेशर. गॉट इट? सो नाउ यू नो अबाउट द वॉर्म एयर. ही हैज गिवन दैट द वॉर्म एयर राइजेस अप एंड इट फॉर्म लो प्रेशर. And when the warm air rises, the air gets cooled in upper layer of atmosphere. So here, air gets cooled in the upper layer of atmosphere, and the cool air sinks down, and again it forms in the high pressure. So again, the high pressure is moved towards to low pressure. Got it? So the high pressure is moved towards the low pressure. So students, now you know about the wind. The air always move from high pressure to low pressure. Got it? Now again back to our topic. So first one in that is uneven heating between the equator and the poles. So students, you already learn in the previous chapter, that is the tropical rainforest region and polar region, right? So for first we are talk about the tropical rainforest area, the tropical areas. So we already discussed, we already know that near the equator, so here the equator is there. Got it? So near the equator, surrounding the equators, there are the tropical areas are located. So sun rays is directly falls on the equators. So that's why this region is very hot, whereas the polar region, here the north pole and here is the south pole. Got it? So there are the two poles, north pole and south pole. So near the equator, surrounding the equator, here the equator surrounding the equator, the tropical region is there, and this one is the very hot because the sun rays is directly falls on the equators, and whereas the polar region is very cold. Got it? So sun falls on the sun rays falls on the equators, that's why this region get maximum heat from the sun. And this is the reason is very hot. Got it? Now here given that the warm air rises up and the cool air from the region in 0 to 30 degree latitude belt on either side of equator moves in, and this wind blow from the north and the south towards the equator. So it means here the equators is given, and here 30 degree north latitude and 30 degree south latitude, right? Got it? So when here the low pressure created and here the high pressure is created. Got it? That's why we learn about that, always the high pressure is moved towards the low pressure. Got it? So that's why the wind move from here to high pressure to low pressure. Got it? So that's why he given that, so this wind blow from the north, it means the 30 degree north latitude to 30 north the south towards the equator, it means north and south. So here 30 degree north and 30 degree south, so winds blow from the equators. Got it? Now after that, what given? After that given is that at the poles, so if we are talk about the polar region here, if we are talk about the polar region here, the high pressure, here the high pressure created, why? Because in this region covered with snow, and it is very cold for most of part of the year, and that's why for a 6 month sun does not set, while for other the 6 month sun does not rise. So that's why here the high pressure is there, got it? But here the 60 degree north latitude and 60 degree south latitude, here 30 degree north and 30 degree south. So 30 degree north and 30 degree south has again low pressure. So that's why the warm air rises up, and here the high pressure fill the gap. It means the high pressure rushes towards the low pressure. So here given that the warm air at this latitude rises up and cold wind from the polar region rushes in to take its place. So in this way, wind circulation is set up from the poles, the warmer latitudes as shown in figure. Got it? So this way, the wind circulation is polar region to tropical region. Got it? Now the next one is that uneven heating on land and water. So students, in chapter 4 we already discussed about the land bridge and sea bridge. Now again recall that what is land bridge and sea bridge. So here during the daytime, it is sea breeze. First I talk about sea breeze. So during the daytime, the lands get heated faster than the water. Here the land and here the sea. So lands get heated faster than the sea water, right? And the air over the land become hot and rises up. And you know very well, when the warm air rises up at that place, the low pressure created. So here the low pressure created. And the low pressure created, so surrounding the high pressure rushes towards the low pressure to fill the gap. Got it? So that's why the warm air rises up and the cool air from the sea rushes towards the land. Got it? Now in the night time, the reverse process. The land gets cool faster than the water. Got it? So this is the land breeze and sea breeze. Now again back to our topic. In summer season, near the equator, the land warm up faster, and most of the time the temperature of the land is higher than the water in the ocean. What happened in summer? In summer, near the equator, and you know very well, on the equator the sun rays falls directly. That's why this region is very hot. It consumes the more amount of heat from the sun. Got it? And near the equator, the land warm up faster, and most of the time temperature of land is higher than the water in oceans. That's why the air over the lands get heated. Same to the sea breeze. Air over the land gets heated and rises up. And you know very well, when the warm air rises up, at that place the low pressure is created, and surrounding the high pressure is rushes towards the low pressure to fill the gap. Got it? So this causes the wind to flow from ocean towards to land. This is called the monsoon wind. Got it? So this wind is called monsoon wind. Now here, but in winter, the direction of wind flows get reversed. It flows from land to ocean. It flows from lands to ocean. Got it? Because the land cools down faster than the ocean. Now the wind from ocean carry the water, bring rain, and it is the part of water cycle. So the winds from the ocean, it carries the moisture, it carries the water droplets. So that's why this water bring rain, and it is the part of water cycle. And the monsoon winds carry the water and its rain, right? And the clouds bring rain and give us happiness. You know very well, you all feel that the clouds bring rain and give us happiness. So farmer in our country mostly depends on rains for their harvests, and there are many folk songs associated with the clouds and rain. We already know about the nursery rhymes, got it? But it is not always a happy ending. So there are the two phases of coin. Same here, it is not always the happy ending. So rains often creates the problem. So heavy rain creates floods, and the lack of rain, it creates the droughts. Got it? So students, our session is over here. Now in next session, we will discuss about thunderstorm and cyclones. Thank you. Have a nice day.